Hello guys, welcome back to Chow Chow 2025. We are settling the ultimate question in ComfyUI face swapping today. Zen-ID versus ReActor. Is Zen-ID the new InstantID based tool the quality king, or is ReActor's speed still unbeatable? I'm running the full comparison. We'll cover full Zen-ID install, the secret to auto masking with SAM2, the final verdict on quality versus speed. Let's dive in. First, the installation. Zen-ID is a custom node, so we need to set it up right. Got to Zen-ID GitHub page, link on video description, scroll down into installation part. Copy the git clone command step 2 line 2 from the GitHub installation part. Go to your ComfyUI custom node folder. In the address bar, type cmd and press enter, paste the command and run it. The node is downloaded. Requirements: we need the dependencies. Copy the install command step 3 line 1. If you use the ComfyUI portable version, navigate to the main directory by typing cd dot dot twice. Then adjust and paste the script, python_embedded/python.exe-m pip install -r/comfyui/comfyui_zenid/requirement.txt. Model download, copy the model download script step 3 line 2, go back into the custom node folder in the command prompt. Run the script. If you use the ComfyUI portable version, follow the script on the screen. This will take a while, so let it run. While waiting, download the Zen-ID Face Swap.json workflow from the GitHub workflow folder and open it in ComfyUI. For model, all the model in this workflow except the XL checkpoint already downloaded. The ControlNet nodes will auto-download, you may just need to adjust the location. Zen-ID uses an XL checkpoint. I'm using the latest RealVis XL Lightning V5.0, link below, but others like DreamShaper XL Lightning also work. The upper image is your target image. The lower image is the face image you want to swap. The biggest difference from ReActor is that you must manually mask the image. Mask only the face and optionally the hair. Do not mask the body as it messes up the result. You can mask the upper chest or neck area as shown here. Now let's add the ReActor node for a direct comparison. The quality difference is clear. Zen-ID handles the details, shading and lighting much better. However, remember the massive trade-off. ReActor is vastly faster and requires less VRAM. Manual masking is too slow for batching. We need to automate this. We already covered segment anything to SAM2 in a previous video, link in the description. I'll fast forward this setup. Create a new group of nodes connected to the original target image. In the Florence 2 run node, type face in the prompt. If you want hair 2, type face and hair, and be sure to delete the index value in the Florence 2 coordinates and check individual object in the SAM2 segmentation node. Connect the output mask from your SAM2 group directly to the mask input of the Zen-ID face swap node. Here are more samples. Automated masking makes the Zen-ID workflow functional. Before we close, let's nail down the key differences, quality versus VRAM. Zen-ID is superior quality because it integrates the swap into the full XL generation InstantID tech, but it is slow and VRAM intensive. ReActor is faster and low VRAM. Video swaps, ReActor wins. Zen-ID is too slow and heavy for video frame processing. Safety. ReActor has an internal safety filter that can be disabled. Check my ReActor upgrade video. Zen-ID relies on the safety features of your main SDXL model. Final takeaway. If you need the highest quality single image and have the VRAM like our RTX 4060 Ti, use Zen-ID. If you need speed or video, stick with ReActor. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to like, share, and comment. Please subscribe to Chow Chow 2025 for more efficient ComfyUI workflows. See you again on the next episode and have a nice day.